Prime Minister Allen Chastanet says the Ministry of Health could not determine the source of infection for the last four cases, none of whom have travel history. The last case is a 14-year-old male student of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. As a result, the school will stay closed for the next 14 days, while all other schools from early childhood to tertiary level will remain closed for 7 days to allow contact tracing. The Prime Minister stressed the need to observe protocols. He reminded the nation that wearing masks, avoiding handshakes and hugging are still in effect. He added that another shutdown would be catastrophic. A cabinet meeting Friday morning led to calls for greater police vigilance to enforce COVID-19 measures. Junequil activities may have to be cancelled.
Please wear your face mask. Please hand sanitize as often as you possibly can. Please limit your interaction as much as possible. Same thing now applies to all of the other public areas that the police have been asked to review and provide greater surveillance.
Prime Minister Chastanet also addressed reports that he was exposed to the virus after distributing tablets to Form 3 students at the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. He says he was not in contact with the student in question. He wore a mask and followed advice to stay home as he awaited COVID-19 test results.
I think it's fair for me to say that the young man did test positive, but he was asymptomatic, and therefore the likelihood of spreading is minimal. In addition to that, he was not in the hall that I was in.
The Castries mayor has been contacted to ensure that vendors follow the guidelines, and the mass crowd maximum, which now stands at 500, has been reduced to 100. Thursday, the Ministry of Education met with stakeholders to put measures in place to deal with possible new cases in schools. The ministry has put together a continuity plan to minimize disruption to the instruction of students while at home.
This week, for example, we distributed several hundred more e-books, I think in total now, whereas initially the e-books project sought to meet the need of some third form students. Now we have expanded that program to other schools.
Health Minister Mary Isaac lamented what she described as the reckless behavior of some by not following the protocols. She says an infected person is refusing to cooperate with the authorities in providing life-saving information. Ms. Isaac spoke of political agendas taking precedence over health and safety issues.
We are not able to shut the country down like we did last time, because for us to do that, many people are going to starve to death. And I believe every one of us here understand what I am saying. We all know of people who are too poor not to go to work and get a decent salary.
Cabinet will make a final decision on the way forward on Monday. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.